Buddy, it's Chris Henry, the Southern Gospel Gardener. Thanks for joining me on another episode of The Opening Act. Today's episode, we're going to open up a CD by Ernie Haase and Signature Sound. Brand new CD called Here We Are Again, and I know you're going to enjoy this album. Also today, we're going to be putting in a vine along a fence to provide some good green coverage, and also another plant that's very common in a lot of yards, but it's going to add a lot of pop and color to wherever I put it. So tune in and let's get to work while we listen to some great Southern Gospel music.
Swinging low, sweet chariot, swinging to carry me home, home, home. Swing, 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 sweet chariot.
All right, so here we are. We've got a space right here by the fence. And I want to fill it in with something. Now, in the winter and spring, we've got a Hercules lily that will grow up, but it, of course, dies off, as all lilies do. And I want something here to be a little bit more permanent, something that's not going to be getting extremely huge and large, something that I can control, but something that's going to add some color in the summer. And that's this particular plant right here. This is a hydrangea. That's pretty common flower. You see these shrubs a lot. Now this one is blue. A lot of times you see hydrangeas that are white or mainly pink, but this is a particular blue hydrangea, and what you want to do to make it blue is add this soil acidifier. And while I clear out this space and plant this, why don't we listen, and we're going to start off listening to this song. This song's just crazy and crazy good. It sounds like it came straight from the Broadway musical of Grease or Hairspray. But let's listen to Ernie Haase sing Every Time.
Trust the one who will never be. And when he comes through,
you'll be saying we'll be every time.
Every time I call upon the Lord,
every time,
he is always sure to keep his word.
Every time,
when I need him, he is never slow.
Every time,
he is with me everywhere I go.
Makes me want to stand right up and makes me want to shout. Makes me want to tell the world what life is all about. Makes me want to raise my hands and makes me want to move. Gotta jump for joy because I know what I'm gonna do.
Every time I call upon the Lord.
What did I tell you? Crazy. It's crazy good. Well, let's get over to the other side of the yard and we'll start working on that vine I was telling you about. Now, Ernie Haase and Signature Sound, they're a great group. They've got great singers. It's great sound, but what really helps them is their producer and their piano player on the road, Wayne Hahn, my favorite producer. He always delivers with some new, fresh, and exciting stuff, especially when he's got somebody like Ernie Haase to kind of team up with and just collaborate in this mad new style of Southern Gospel music. Wayne Hahn's just a great producer, but he's always looking so grim in his pictures.
Squirrel!
And what's the deal with that, Wayne? Smile, lighten up. You're a great producer. You're the best producer in the music, according to Southern Gospel Gardener. Anyway, right here, what we've got is the vine that I was telling you about. Now, this is an unusual vine. It's called a kiwi vine. Now, you may be familiar with the kiwi fruit. It's just a small, it looks like a small brown egg that you could fit in the palm of your hand. It's real fuzzy. And it's funny, now the leaves and the vine on a kiwi vine are fuzzy just like a kiwi. The trick is you gotta have a male and a female. Make sure when you buy one from your local store that you're buying one and it's got the male and the female in the same pot so that they cross-pollinate and you can get those fruit. Otherwise, it's just a vine, just another vine that's gonna crawl all over your fence. But we want something that's gonna taste really good. And so what you're gonna need today is a hammer and some nails and some baling wire. Now this wire is going to, we're going to make a crisscross pattern. So, and make sure when you're using the baling wire, you use gloves. Otherwise, the other thing that you're going to need is a tetanus shot. While I'm going to start on the wall, putting the nails and the wire on it, why don't we listen to, it's a great song, written by Ernie Haase and Wayne Hahn, Any Other Man. And I want you to listen to this. Man, Devin McGlamory, good old buddy of mine from way back in the Dixie Melody Boys days, great singer, Doug Anderson, the group, man, it's just gonna sound great. I can't wait to hear this live. Any Other Man.
Any other man who was sentenced to be killed would beg for mercy from the courts that day. just wasn't any other man.
Any Other Man. Boy, that is a great song right there. And you know, Ernie Haase wrote that, and Ernie Haase and Wayne Hahn, they helped write about, I think it's 7 or 8 songs on this album. And you know, Ernie writes a lot of great songs. He writes a lot of songs, and what people don't know, may not know, is that he wrote the last number one song by the Cathedrals, that's a pretty big deal, I would say. You know, you never hear Ernie Haase's name mentioned with people like Rodney Griffin, Jim Brady, Ronnie Henson. Well, maybe you should, because Ernie is a great songwriter. And of course, if Ernie's ever looking for another songwriter to help him out in his group, write some songs, I mean, that's always a possibility, right? Anyway, we're going to get this baling wire onto these nails. We've got all our nails placed in 1 foot increments, and we're going to make a crisscross pattern. And right now we're going to listen to their bass singer, Ian Owens. Now, I know Ian's fairly new to the group, and he's replacing a legend in Tim Duncan. And my first thoughts were, well, who is this kid who's going to try to sing like Tim Duncan? Ian Owens, that's who. And let me tell you about Ian. He's got pedigree. He's got it in his genetics. His dad, Butch, has sung with groups like with the Stamps, with the Florida Boys, and sang with several other Southern Gospel groups. He's a great bass singer, and his son, Ian, is just as great. And he's young, which means he's got a ton of potential. You know, I went to Stamps Baxter School back in 1990 with a kid named Gene McDonald who really wanted to sing bass, and he was almost there. Well, now look at him. He's on the Gaither videos. Ian is already beyond what I heard from Gene McDonald over 20 years ago. Ian's got a great voice, and I want you to listen to a song made famous by Elvis Presley and J.D. Sumner called I Believe.
I believe for every drop of rain that falls, a flower grows. I believe that somewhere in the darkest night, a candle glows. I believe for everyone who goes astray, someone will come to show the way.
So we're going to put our kiwi vine right here behind the queen's palm and between it and the fence and this new elephant ear that's popping up. I'm gonna put it right here, let it spread along the fence. And while we're doing that, let's listen to my favorite song on the album featuring Mr. Doug Anderson. And Dove Award winner, Doug Anderson, Sometimes I Wonder.
Sometimes I wonder, sometimes I wonder. Do you ever see the sights and think this must be some fantastic dream? Can you wrap your mind around the things you see? Or is it more than you can comprehend? To think today will never end, and all is peace and joy eternally.
All right, we've got our kiwi vine now on the wire trellis. I have a feeling that this thing's gonna get real big, and I'm gonna have to probably buy some wooden trellises that will expand that way and that way so that it has plenty of room to grow, plenty of room to spread, and bears us lots of fruit. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this episode of the Southern Gospel Gardeners opening act featuring Ernie Haase and Signature Sound. And the wind is blowing away some black bark. I'm gonna lay down some black bark while we finish out this episode. And maybe we'll close out with one more song. Signature song.
I will not worry or doubt anymore. I've been